and welcome to Finextra TV. We're here at Money 2020 Europe, and kindly joining me now in the press lounge is Nikki Cubman from AV. Hello, Nikki.
Hi.
Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Hannah.
So how are you enjoying the event so far?
It's very nice. I absolutely love the fact that it's actually in my hometown. So it's really nice to see all these great companies coming here. We have great meetings. It's a chance to really catch up on all the industry players. And besides the great conference, actually there's great outside events as well. Yeah, it's wonderful.
I couldn't agree more. So next, I want to talk to you a little bit about merchants' needs. I mean, could you tell us, what do you think they are?
Yeah, if you look at merchant needs, I think you really need to look at what a merchant needs to do in order to survive in their, well, daily lives. Really in the basics of it, it hasn't really changed from even the 18th century, right? It's two things where you need to really know your profession and love it and be the best at what you do. And at the same time, be extremely customer focused and offer that service. The big thing that did change is the fact that the digital world has, well, exploded, and therefore a merchant needs to really try to catch up and stay up to date with all the different developments that are happening. And that effectively would mean that right now, and especially AV, we focus at the SMB space, that offering those type of merchants the same tools as the big tier one, tier twos could afford already for, well, a decade. Giving them those tools, they can actually be still the professional as they are, giving the love and attention to their customers, but being capable of communicating with those customers that are extremely digital savvy within the right channels.
Sure, all right. Yeah. Well, following up on that quite nicely then, what makes value-added apps and services attractive to the merchants and the acquirers?
Well, what makes it attractive to them is that right now, with this changing world, SaaS products actually become better and more available to merchants. Where back in the days, these type of solutions would be extremely costly, extremely focused on a specific company, where today you see a lot of developers designing really great solutions, such as your loyalty solution, could be an appointment booking solution or an employee scheduling solution. And they're really affordable for the smaller merchants, and they're extremely effective for their business, where, for example, implementing the right type of loyalty solution could actually up your business 11% of having 11% returning customers, which is great for your business, right? I think in the end, it's all about the question, how do you, as a merchant, identify the right solution, where if you're not tech-savvy at all, it's already difficult enough, but then if you are tech-savvy and you look for a specific solution, it's very difficult to identify the one out there all. And to give an example, if you go to the Google Play Store and you would, for example, look at POS systems, there's over 150 out there, where, wow, how do you select that one that suits your business, right? So yeah.
Well, you've sadly touched on it already, but what are the benefits, and could you highlight the obstacles as well?
Yeah, so benefits are very clear. Being capable of communicating with your customers and being capable of actually giving them what these really digital savvy clients want, right? Being capable of competing with the big boys. So just imagine you have this really cool, fancy coffee shop. You're completely coffee crazy. And then all of a sudden there's a Starbucks, and on the other end, Nero comes in. You are a professional, you know your stuff, you love your customers, but you also want to give them that extra, right, to be capable of competing. So implementing a loyalty solution there could be a great great advantage for them. Ordering ahead, where Starbucks is extremely famous for, it's also within reach and actually within a very cost-efficient way. So that is definitely the upside. Then the downside, or actually the challenge in that, is making sure that you use the right solution for your business, and that it's, well, value versus money, right? How to implement it, that it works seamlessly together. It's not necessarily said that if you download a POS solution and besides that you would do a loyalty solution, that they seamlessly would work together. That type of expertise, I think that is really what the key is in creating a solution that works for everyone, yeah.
Fantastic, all right. And finally then, how could an inquirer respond to all these different needs from different types of merchants?
Yeah, well, and that is really the key, I think, from looking at merchant acquirers, the danger where they are playing right now is that they are payment providers. And in order to take the next step, and also where you see all these mergers taking place right now, is moving from being a payments provider into becoming a solution provider. And the good news in that is that payments is very much cost-based, right? Where being a solution provider is very much about value adding to your customer, so to the merchant. So for these merchant acquirers, in order to move into this space, it takes two things. One is obviously KYC, really know your customer, know who they are, know their challenges, know their needs, and therefore really start tailor-making solutions that would fit them. But equally important is actually the internal change, where merchant acquirers are well, great companies, but they usually are not completely set up to really add and support those value-added services, because there's a great deal of customer service involved. Also equally understanding what type of providers are out there, what type of solutions, how to implement, and even more important, how to sell it to a merchant, right? And the good news is that companies like AV are out there that we really want to support those merchant acquirers with being next generation ready and offering that value and that relationship again mm-hmm. with their merchants.
Fantastic. Yeah. So watch this space, I think it's safe to say.
Absolutely. Watch it, and it's not going away. It's only going to explode more. So yeah.
Fantastic. Nikki, thank you so much for sharing your insights. I'll let you get back to the event. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you, Anna.
And thank you for watching.